Thomas More, though you have heinously offended the King's Majesty, we hope, if you will even now forthink and repent of obstinate opinion, you may still taste his gracious pardon.
That you did willfully and maliciously deny and deprive our liege Lord Henry of his undoubted certain title, supreme head of the church in England.
But I have never denied this title.
At Westminster Hall, at Lambeth, and again at Richmond, you stubbornly refused the oath. Was this no denial?
No, this was silence. And for my silence, I am punished with imprisonment.
Why have I been called again?
Under charge of high treason, Sir Thomas.
For which the punishment is not imprisonment.
Death comes for us all, my lords. Yes, even for kings he comes.
The death of kings is not in question, Sir Thomas.
Nor mine, I trust, until I'm proven guilty.
Your life lies in your own hands, Thomas, as it always has.
Is that so, my lord? Then I'll keep a good grip on it.
Marriage. On the 12th of May, you were at the Tower.
I was.
For what purpose?
I was sent to carry away the prisoner's books.
Did you talk with the prisoner?
Yes.
Did you talk of the king's supremacy of the church?
Yes.
What did you say?
I said to him, supposing there were an act of parliament to say that I, Richard Rich, were to be king, would not you, Master More, take me for king? That I would, he said. For then you would be king.
Yes.
Then he said, but I will put you a higher case. How if there were an act of parliament to say that God should not be God?
This is true, and then you
said... Continue.
Then I said, I will put you a middle case. Parliament has made our king head of the church. Why will you not accept him?
Well,
then he said, Parliament had not the power to do it.
Repeat the prisoner's words.
He said, Parliament had not the competence. Or words to that effect.
Oh, he denied the title.
He did.
In good faith, Rich, I am sorrier for your perjury than my peril.
Do you deny this?
Yes. My lords, you know if I were a man who heeded not the taking of an oath, I need not be here. Now I will take an oath. If what Master Rich has said is true, I pray I may never see God in the face, which I would not say were it otherwise, for anything on earth.
That is not evidence.
Is it probable? Is it probable that after so long a silence on this the very point so urgently sought of me, I should open my mind to such a man as that?
Sir Richard, do you wish to modify your testimony?
No, my lord.
Is there anything you wish to take away from it?
No, my lord.
Have you anything to add?
No, my lord.
Have you, Sir Thomas?
To what purpose? I am a dead man. You have your will of me.
Sir Thomas More, you have been found guilty of high treason. Sentence of the court.
My lords, when I was practicing law, the manner was to ask the prisoner before pronouncing sentence if he had anything to say.
Have you anything to say?
Yes.
Since the court has determined to condemn me, God knoweth how, I will now discharge my mind concerning the indictment and the king's title. The indictment is grounded in an act of Parliament which is directly repugnant to the law of God and his holy church, the supreme government of which no temporal person may by any law presume to take upon him. This was granted by the mouth of our Savior Christ himself to St. Peter and the bishops of Rome whilst he lived and was personally present here on earth. It is therefore insufficient in law to charge any Christian to obey it. And more to this, the immunity of the church is promised both in Magna Carta and in the king's own coronation oath.
Now we plainly see you are malicious.
Not so. I am the king's true subject, and I pray for him and all the realm. I do none harm. I say none harm. I think none harm. And if this be not enough to keep a man alive, then in good faith I long not to live. Nevertheless! It is not for the supremacy that you have sought my blood, but because I would not bend to the marriage.
You have been found guilty of high treason. The sentence of the court is that you be taken from the court to the Tower of London. Until
I am commanded by the king to be brief, and since I am the king's obedient subject, brief I will be. I die his majesty's good servant, but God's first.
I forgive you right readily.
Not afraid of your office. You send me to God.
You're very sure of that, Sir Thomas?
He will not refuse one who is so blithe to go to him.